Well, I did enough research. You don't live very long with melanoma, stage 4 cancer. But in every end of my mind, I was still going to go through and whatever it was. The research that they do is amazing. I'm Johnny Borgstrom. I'm 70 years old. I live in Big Cabin, Oklahoma. I was diagnosed with melanoma cancer January the 10th of 2018. I noticed that in October of 2017 that I had a bump on top of my head. By November, the spot on my head had enlarged to about a nickel size. And then in December, it had grown larger, about a quarter size, and it raised up and started bleeding. My daughter works for urgent care, and she had her nurse call to find a dermatologist. So on January the 5th, he took a biopsy of it, called me on a Tuesday, said it was fast aggressive melanoma cancer. And he'd already set me up with a surgeon in Tulsa, and the surgeon called me and set up the appointment for the surgeries. I had 3 surgeries. My last one was March the 2nd. They sent me to another place, and they said it had leaked into my lungs. I was wanting a second opinion. My daughter called my wife, Debbie, and said, would Dad consider going to MD Anderson in Houston, Texas? Eventually, I said, yes, I will go to MD Anderson. So they gave me a lung biopsy, and they confirmed that it was melanoma in my lungs. So immediately, they started to do testing and going through everything. And then finally, they came to a diagnosis and a treatment. They were going to start me on immunotherapy, double dose, twice a month. But meanwhile, while I was waiting to start the treatment, he came up and found out that there was a trial that had started 2 weeks earlier of giving this medicine to the melanoma patients. So he asked me if I would consider doing a double-blind study trial. And I looked at him like, well, what is that? And he explained it out to me, and I told him, yes, I will do it. I did study on melanoma that with the stage that I had, you don't live very long. So I told him, I said, if you can study me, and if it'll save a little child's life or another adult's life, and I don't make it, that's fine. Let's do it. And we started the treatment on June the 4th of 2018. My research nurse, she handled everything. She handled all the scheduling. She handled everything that I needed. If I had something that came up here at home, I would call her. She would get to the doctor. They'd get right back to me whether I could do this or not, whether I could take a medicine or not, or where, you know, it could be done. It was like a big family. It was like a team effort that they were part of my family. And we felt like we were part of their family. It was just a great experience. I went through the trial. I was there every 28 days. I had to do an infusion. By the 12th month, the tumors had totally disappeared. I continued till May the 4th of 2020, and I got to ring the bell. Yeah. It was during the COVID, so the family couldn't be there. But all my infusion nurses met in the hall where the bell was for me to ring it. They don't say in MD Anderson, you're cancer-free, it has recessed. And from March the 4th of 2020, I still have no cancer. I've done scans every 12 weeks. Nothing has ever showed up. My energy and everything is back to normal, and I really feel good about it. What I would say to other patients, don't be afraid of a trial. The research that they do is amazing. They take the greatest care of you. They watch what you do, and you're not alone. They're there with you all the time. I would say cancer researchers, keep doing what you're doing. Keep looking for new medicines to cure cancer. Keep up the good work. Congressmen, congresswomen, you need to fund this. You need to keep it up. You need to keep going with this. It's saving lives through these trials.